In this screencast, I'm going to describe the operation of a single effect evaporator, which is mostly used to remove water from an aqueous solution in order to concentrate the solution. This may be a solution that contains sugar, sodium chloride, or orange juice, and the final objective is this concentrated solution. So what we're going to look at is a schematic representation of the single effect evaporator. So in this schematic representation, we have a feed coming in, which is a liquid, and we're going to remove vapor and therefore end up with a concentrated liquid leaving the system. So we'll label this feed F in kilograms per hour coming in, and it's going to come in with the concentration of the solute, the solids that are dissolved, a mass fraction x of f. Vapor is going to be pure solvent, which in general, most of the systems we're looking at, this is water. So that means the mole fraction of solute is zero there. And then we have the liquid. So this is the concentrated liquid. This is our objective, is to create this concentrated liquid. And so we have mass fraction liquid. Mass fraction liquid is greater than the mass fraction in the feed. A couple of things to note. Remember, this is a dilute liquid. Feed temperature is less than the temperature in the evaporator. We're going to call this temperature T of the evaporator. We're going to assume this is well mixed. So this is important. Assuming this is well mixed, temperature here, are also the evaporator temperature. And this is because this is mixed in the evaporator sufficiently such that we have no gradients in temperature. So the pressure in the evaporator is going to determine what the evaporation temperature is for the system. The other aspect of this single effect evaporator is that we have steam coming in to cause the evaporations. So we're going to have steam, which is causing the evaporation. So we'll have steam flow comes into the evaporator and moves through, same flow rate of steam then leaves the evaporator. It's also kilograms per hour. Temperature to steam, and we're going to assume this is saturated steam, quality of 1, and here we're assuming all the steam is condensed, so then the liquid is dripping out of the exchanger tube. So this is at the same temperature. So let's just look at some of the governing equations for this system. One would be a mass balance, and we'll do the mass balance on the overall feed. So this feed coming in is split into two streams, liquid plus vapor. And then we can do a mass balance on the solute, the solids, so the mass fraction in the feed times the flow rate. The only place the solids leave are in the liquid phase, the mass fraction of the liquid times the mass flow rate of the liquid leaving. So this is our mass balances for this system. One of the energy balances that is important for this single effect evaporator is the heat transfer. So the heat transfer rate, this is kilojoules per hour equal to an overall heat transfer coefficient. So this heat transfer coefficient is taking into account all of the heat transfer, both sides of the heat transfer tubing. So it's kilojoules per square meter per hour per degree Kelvin. Heat transfer area, which would be in square meters, and then the temperature difference. So the steam temperature, which of course is higher than the evaporating temperature. The bigger this temperature difference, of course, the faster the heat transfer. And so these are the basic equations. We now also have to do enthalpy balances on the streams that we'll look at in a subsequent screencast. There are more efficient ways to carry out evaporation, for example, a triple effect evaporator to have 3 of these in series. That saves a significant cost on the steam, but adds a cost of the construction. And so It's a trade-off of the relative cost of, if steam is cheap, then this might be the better approach.